We will begin the GBM series, an adaptive boosting method, with the 10th module of machine learning. This video is part 1 and will cover the training and prediction process of the GBM. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. And the audio was generated by AI. TTS. Let's take a look at the full table of contents of the GBM series. The GBM part also consists of regression and classification. Chapter 1 provides an overview of the GBM. Chapter 2 examines the regression algorithm. We explore the training and prediction process and analyze the regression algorithm in detail. And we will implement the GBM and SGBM regression algorithms in code. Chapter 3 examines the binary classification algorithm of GBM. We will look at the training and prediction process, and analyze the classification algorithm. And then implement it as code. And in Chapter 4, we will look at the multiclass classifications. We will get an overview of multiclass classification and implement it in code. Let's take a look at the outline of the GBM. GBM is a boosting-based ensemble learning algorithm. Train multiple weak learners and aggregate the results of those learners to make predictions. Decision trees are used as the weak learners. GBM was proposed by Leo Bryman in 1997 and updated by Jeremy Friedman in 1999. Since then, it has developed into XGBoost and LightGBM, etc. GBM is applicable to both regression and classification and is characterized by training on the residuals of the target data. If your training data is like this, you initially set the initial estimate to the overall average value. This red line is the initial prediction. Then calculate the residuals of each data point. The residual for this data point is about this size. And the residual for this data point is about this size. And in the next round, we will split this node at this location. Let's say the prediction for the data on the left is this straight line. And the prediction for the data on the right is this straight line. We then use these two predictions to calculate new residuals for every data point. The residuals will be smaller than before. We then split each node again at this location and at this location. And recalculate the new residuals with the new predictions. Then the residuals will continue to decrease. By repeating this process, the final regression line will look like this. GBM is an algorithm that increases prediction accuracy while continuously reducing residuals. Now let's take a look at the training process of GBM regression. We will look at how the GBM algorithm works through a simple example. This example is from this video, Gradient Boost Part 1 on YouTube StatQuest. Let's take a look at the data below. This data has feature X and target Y like this. It consists of three features. And the target Y is all real values. And there are a total of six training data points like this. The first step is to calculate the overall average value of the target Y and use that as the initial prediction. The overall average value of the target Y is 71.2. The second step is to calculate the residual as the difference between the actual y value and the initial prediction. Calculate this residual by subtracting the initial prediction from the target y of each data point. For the second data point, we also calculate the residual in the same way. This is the residuals calculated from the first iteration round. The first subscript indicates the data point number, and the second subscript indicates the iteration round number. The third step is to create and train a decision tree using the feature X and the residuals R, rather than the target Y. Let's assume that the generated tree is as follows. For the first data point, the gender is male, so we move it to the right. And since its favorite color is blue, it belongs to the fourth leaf node of this tree. For the third data point, the gender is female, so we move it to the left. And since its height is 1.5, we move it to the left again. And it belongs to the first leaf node of this tree. In this way, a total of 6 training data points are assigned to each leaf node. Calculating the average of each leaf node value yields the leaf value. This is the new residual of each data point estimated using this tree. In the fourth step, we predict the next target Y and calculate the second residuals. The predicted Y is F1. F1 is calculated like this. By multiplying the predicted residuals by the learning rate and adding the initial estimate F0, we get the predicted Y value F1. We then calculate the second residuals using the difference between the actual and predicted Y. For each data point, let's calculate the new predicted Y value, F1. The predicted residual for the first data point is 16.8. Using the initial estimate of Y and the predicted residual, the new predicted Y is 72.88. For the third data point, the predicted residual is -14.7. Applying the predicted residual to the initial estimate of Y gives a new predicted Y of 69.73. Now, using the new predicted Y and the actual Y value, we compute the second residuals as follows. For the first data point, this part is 72.88. So the second residual would be 15.1. In this way, we calculate the new residuals for each data point. This shows that the new residuals are smaller than the previous ones. And you can see that the estimates for each data point are also closer to the actual values than the initial estimates. For the first data point, the initial estimate is 71.2 and the actual Y value is 88. We can see that the new estimate is closer to the actual value. On the previous page, we calculated the residuals up to the second iteration round. The next step is to create a new tree using the feature data X and the second residuals. In this example, the split points for this tree were represented as the same as the first tree. But in reality, each tree has different split points. The residual of the first training data point belongs to the fourth leaf node. and the residual of the third training data point belongs to the first leaf node. Then, we calculate the average of each leaf node values to predict the new residuals. In the next step, we calculate the third residuals using the predicted residuals by the two trees. For the first training data point, the actual Y value is 88, and the initial estimate is 71.2. This is the Y value predicted using the first tree. In this part, we add the residual predicted by the second tree. The third residual is 13.6. The second residual of the first data point is 15.1. And the second residual of the third data point is -13.2. Use these values to calculate the third residuals for all data points. These are the third residuals. The residuals are calculated using this formula, where F2 is calculated using this formula, and the F1 was calculated using this formula. This shows that the third residuals are smaller than the second residuals. As iterations progress, these residuals become smaller and the estimates become more accurate. Repeat this process until the residuals are no longer reduced. This is the training process. And the tree models created during the training process are saved for the later prediction process. Meanwhile, in 1999, Friedman proposed stochastic gradient boosting, SGB. SGB samples the data without replacement each time a tree is created in each iteration round. SGB is a widely used approach to regularization of boosting models based on decision trees. The key to the GBM training process is to gradually reduce the residuals. As the residuals decrease, the predicted Y values become closer and closer to the actual Y values. Estimate the initial Y value, compute the residual, use this residual to predict the new Y value. And use this prediction to compute the next residual, and repeat this process over and over again. This time, we will look at the prediction process. Let's look at the test data below. What we want to do is predict the target Y value for this test data point. We can predict the target Y value of this test data point using the tree models that we saved in the training process. Let's say that the two saved trees are as follows. Let's input this test data point into the first tree. The gender is female and the height is less than 1.6. Therefore, this test data point belongs to the first leaf node in this tree. The average value for this leaf node is -14.7. This is the predicted residual of the test data point. This is not a predicted value of target Y. This is because the tree was created using the residuals. Now let's input this test data point into the second tree. In the second tree, it also belongs to the first leaf node. Because its gender is female and its height is 1.5. And the predicted residual value is -13.2. In this example, both trees have the same split points. But in reality, the split points will be different. For example, in the second tree, this test data point might belong to the second or the third leaf node. Now let's use this predicted residual to estimate the target Y of the test data point. This formula is used for this. F0 is the initial predicted Y value calculated by the training data. Entering the test data point into the first tree results in a predicted residual value of -14.7. And entering this into the second tree results in a predicted residual value of -13.2. Multiply each predicted residual by the learning rate. And add them all together to get 68.41. This is the predicted Y value of this test data point. Therefore, the weight of this test data is estimated to be 68.41. To simplify the example, we only used two trees here. But in reality, multiple trees are generated during training. Repeat training until the residuals no longer decrease. These values will continue to be added. However, the values to be added get smaller and smaller. This is the prediction process of GBM. So far, we have looked at an overview of GBM. And looked at the training and prediction process for the regression algorithm through a simple example. In the next video, we will analyze this algorithm in more detail.